For nearly a century, the North Red and Purple Lines have been an integral part of the growth and success of the communities they connect. But now, the Red and Purple Lines have reached the end of their useful lifespans. Most tracks and bridges are now nearly 100 years old. Continuing to operate a busy rail line on this outdated infrastructure results in unusually high maintenance costs, the need for frequent repairs that disrupt service and slow travel, and outdated, inadequate stations that can't accommodate modern amenities for customers. To address these issues, the Chicago Transit Authority is undertaking the largest capital improvement project in its history, the Red and Purple Modernization Program, or RPM. This major initiative will be completed in phases to rebuild the northern portion of the Red and Purple Lines from Belmont to Howard Station, and the Purple Line, which extends further north to the Linden Station in Wilmette. RPM accommodates current and future ridership needs by comprehensively upgrading tracks and reconstructing stations. RPM will also increase the number of passengers that pass through these stations by expanding the number of trains that can travel on the Red Line, an improvement that will allow CTA to better serve customers for generations to come. By building the RPM project in phases, CTA can provide great improvements while minimizing impacts to passengers on CTA's most traveled line. Phase 1 includes two main components, the Red-Purple Bypass Project and the Lawrence to Bryn Mawr Modernization Project.
Your attention, please. We are standing momentarily waiting for signal clearance. We expect to be moving shortly.
Sound familiar? Construction of a new Red-Purple Bypass north of Belmont Station would eliminate the need for Red, Purple, and Brown Line trains to stop and wait for crossing trains, increasing the speed of all trains traveling through this area. The new bypass would reduce delays for all three lines and allow CTA to accommodate more than 7,200 riders per hour through the busy corridor as ridership grows. Also included in RPM Phase 1 is the complete reconstruction of the Lawrence, Argyle, Berwyn, and Bryn Mawr stations to include modern amenities and elevators to make them fully accessible to customers with disabilities. During Phase 1, CTA would also rebuild all tracks, support structures, bridges, and viaducts on the mile-plus stretch between these stations, improving train speed and reliability. RPM Phase 1 will also create thousands of good-paying jobs, including nearly 6,000 direct design and construction jobs. Future phases of RPM would bring the same level of infrastructure and station improvements to the Red and Purple Lines north of Belmont to Linden Station in Wilmette, and are contingent upon funding availability. In moving RPM forward, the city can leverage more than $1 billion in federal funding for Phase 1 of the project, which would pay for half of the total estimated $2.1 billion cost. However, in order to secure these federal funds, a local funding match is required. In June 2016, the Illinois General Assembly approved a new financial tool for this purpose, known as Transit Tax Increment Financing, or the Transit TIF for short. Transit TIF is an economic development tool to support investment in large-scale, long-term transit projects. Transit TIF funds are created by growth in property value, known as increment, that occurs because of the investment in transit. The RPM Transit TIF would support the RPM project only, providing a portion of the needed matching funds. Without these local matching funds the Transit TIF will provide, Chicagoans would likely have to pay the full cost of the project. RPM is just one part of CTA's Red Ahead program, a comprehensive initiative to maintain, modernize, and expand Chicago's most traveled rail line. For the most up-to-date information on the Red-Purple Modernization Program, visit our website at transitchicago.com/RPM project. You can also join the contact list by sending an email request to rpm@transitchicago.com.